but it's pretty here. Back to Hearthstone. Pretty much picking up right where I was off last time. I just took a quick break, and now I'm back, and we're gonna do some more ranked. So, if you didn't watch yesterday's episode, I showed off my deck at first, and then I did one game, and the game was too long that it basically filled up the entire episode. It's kind of a disappointing game. I had no board control at all throughout the entire game, and he had, like, a raid leader and a void walker up for the, like, majority of the game, and by the time I started getting some board control, he just had both his Hellfires, and it was whatever. I, like, really couldn't come back from it. And then he got some more shit on the board that I just couldn't get rid of because I didn't have any spells. Anyway, so against Priest as a mage, I normally feel fairly confident, but I'm probably going to get rid of this Water Elemental for a 2-drop. Try to, anyway. So I turned a 4-drop into a 5-drop. So I have nothing to play turn 2, unless I top deck it.
Is someone injured?
That's dying. I'm gonna frost with that. I absolutely refuse to leave one of those on the board. I hate those cards so much. That's even worse though, sadly. So basically what I'm expecting him to do is going to put bunch of buffs on it, and then turn it into a attacking minion with power within, or inner fire I think it is. So he's gonna buff this up a lot, and I know it. It's gonna happen. Does he have all the mana to do it already? No, he doesn't. He's just gonna do that. Okay. Alright, so
what to do?
That's actually a pain in the ass. If I attack anything, that's just gonna heal it once I have more minions out. So what I wanna do, reduce the damage that's gonna do and damage that. So that has two targets to heal rather than just one. And it healed the wrong target, of course. That's fine. Next turn I'll probably put a Sludge Belcher out just to protect me for a little while. And depends. If he doesn't play anything this turn, then I'll probably work in Intellect and attack the kill that probably. Alright, that's kind of painful. Great, he gets two of my cards. That's quite annoying. Alright, so what am I going to do this turn? I need to start working on getting rid of that. Same time, I also want to get rid of that. So I think I'm just going to stick to my original plan. I'm going to get rid of the light bow so it can't buff it. Sadly, he's already buffing this, so that's not good. If I get a fireball, I get a fireball.
Is the light spawn really worth a fireball?
I don't know. Next turn, I can go taunt up, though, which will eliminate the damage I take. I don't mind taking much damage against some priests because they don't have a lot of dark damage. Though they do have mind blast if they actually run it. So I'm not necessarily worried about the light spawn. You got a fireball? Are you kidding me? Hell, I don't even have a fireball in my hand right now. Alright, so are you going to increase its damage or are you going to work on killing it? I should hit that with that in truth. I would put it down to a 4 and then it wouldn't be able to kill that unless it heals it. Let me guess, you got one of my fireballs. Or the other fireball. So, as I was now I'm kind of eating my words because I don't have anything I can do against that. So let's make sure he has to heal it to be able to kill it. So that forces him into doing one thing. So I have 3 health. I literally can't take anything if he has a mind blast, or if he has just 2 direct damage, like with his or 1 damage. Holy Nova? No. too early to be saying well played, Bodhi. Now you're past appeals. Unless you have another one, of course, and then, in which case, then I fucking lose. Especially because I run zero healing. He has direct damage. Alright. That's unfortunate. He got my fireball. I couldn't really do much to the buffed up light spawn. I pretty much lost early. And four, I drop rank. Hooray. Yep. So, we're going to fit the second one in this episode. I'm still contemplating if I'm going to do two episodes for today, or if it's going to be only one. If you see a second episode a little bit later on the day, well, then I obviously decided on putting a second episode out. Which I very well may, because I did miss out on Thursday, and kind of do how I'd make up for it.
I must protect.
Really hope I don't lose every single game I play today. Really hope. Let's see if I can't get my knife juggler. I have 1 in 30 chances to get it. Instead, I got my ooze. I mean, this is not a bad hand in any stretch of the imagination. I have a 2, 3, 4 play. All of them are pretty decent. And I got a flesh eating ghoul, so that's always interesting. So he plays a bunch of low health minions, so he's not a paladin. And the highest I've ever gotten one of these is 16, 16. But I still need to go get that video off of stream. Really? Coin for wild growth? It's an interesting play, I guess. Now the real question here is, like, do I golem or do I ghoul first? That's a real question. I'm gonna hit the ooze or my face? Probably my face. Yeah, it's a better play. So I think I golem. Golem has more early game potential. He's already up to 4 mana, which is fine. It doesn't really matter if he doesn't have late game, which I have a decent late game. Sorry about the dogs. As you can probably guess, I'm recording this during the daytime. Because I'm trying to deal with, like, actually being...
Yes, me and Mr.
White. Next turn, I'll select culture. I'll force them into trading things. For next turn, I could not. Yeah. All right, so I have decent control right now. Could easily be, yeah, swipe territory. So I got one of his two swipes for one card. That's fine. So I'm going to Chaz Dingo. Or wait, am I? No. Get rid of this spell. And I'll give that 4-3. I have a 2-1 to go with it. He'll probably pass and get rid of that, but that'll buff that up even more. If he doesn't have a silence or a 3 damage, which... He could have wrath, I guess, which would screw me, but... I don't know. I don't really openly play around early cards like that. Is he really gonna give himself 2 mana? No, he's not. He's gonna drop cards. It's a really good card. I actually got it from my Druid deck. I don't remember if I'm using it or not. Alright, so this turn we will select and attack his face. And if he plays anything deadly, then I have polymorph. So next turn when he has this big 8 mana cards, I can just polymorph it and GG. More than that, he does have that. I could do two different things. I could polymorph that, or I could fireball it. Either would be a bad play. I will polymorph it. Rip or golem. That's all you can do this turn, buddy. Thank you. And rip! Alright, so this game I'm actually doing well. It's amazing. Sadly, now I don't have a fire or a polymorph for that. I only have a fireball, but I have a fireball plus this for anything he drops with 10 or 8 health. So that's fine. Next turn, I could actually win.
Where shall I strike?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I win this turn.
Where shall I strike?
All right, no, I don't. Okay, I'm a big fat liar. Let's see. Fireball's gonna happen. I win. Yay! I forgot all about that Frostbolt. Anyway, so I actually got to win a game! It's a miracle, right? Oh my god. Alright, so... anyway. I think it's gonna be end this one. It's gonna be a little bit... oh god, I forgot I had that fucking daily. That's gonna be it for this episode. I might put out another one today. It'll probably, like, I'll delay them, like, one will go up at, like, 10 AM, one will go up at, like, 4 PM or something. I don't know, I'll decide how I'm gonna do it. Anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed these. If you do really like them, share some love with them, give them some likes, or comment on them, or just give me some kind of, like, way to know that you guys like these. I mean, view count alone, yeah, I can look at the views. If people are viewing these, then great. If they don't, well, then I'll have to figure out something for next week. Anyway, this is about it. I will see you guys later. Bye.